The holdfast is the attachment point of the algae, which is like an anchor. The holdfast holds the plant to a rock or in the sand to a shell, and from that then the plant can then move to and fro with the wave movement in the water.
Several years ago, Sally and I came down to Port Mac. We were having a field trip to look at migrating birds, and the birds were off in a distance and very hard to see and quite tiny. But there was so much algae floating in the water, and the way it was floating, it looks just so magical and it's so free, and the colours, you know, they become brighter.
I was pointing out some of the algae to Jo, and she was very interested. And after that, we sort of talked about maybe working together in the art medium to represent some of these particular plants.
I was surprised that Sally knew all the scientific names, so I thought I'd better check them out too. I still don't know a lot of the scientific names. I have to go to Sally and ask her, or Kyatt. Very handy people to have around.
I studied marine botany at university over 50 years ago, and that sort of opened my eyes to a whole new world.
Wrack on the beach, or some people might refer to it as drift, seaweed drift, it's basically just seaweed that was attached at some point that's come dislodged during a storm and sort of drifted in with the ocean currents. There's an awful lot of it here. There's a lot of productivity in the ocean right behind us, particularly because of the shallow water and the bonny upwelling. There's a lot of seaweed growth.
The bonny upwelling starts from the Victorian border and goes through up to about Robe.
I'd say a lot of the local diversity comes down to the high levels of nutrient in the water from the upwelling off the coast here, and that's mainly because of the continental shelf being relatively close to the coast, and we get a really intense form of upwelling just along here, and that feeds the seaweed growth, it feeds animal growth as well, and it feeds into all of our coastal industries.
Well, Port MacDonnell is important because of the huge diversity of algae that we have right here in this region. There are more species here than in any other part of the world because of the cool temperature of the ocean and also because of the bonny upwelling.
The swell gets quite big here, so it rips it off and drags it in. And some of the things that we find in the wrack are incredibly special and rare along this coast.
The inspiration comes from the algae itself. Some of the work that I've been doing is oil paintings, watercolours and printmaking. So the different techniques to show different aspects of the algae.
My work is mainly textiles, and I'm representing the algae through knitting, crocheting, felting, patchwork. A lot of my works will be installations, and they're quite big pieces. One of the things that I have learned through the project, and that is the macrocystis, the one with the bladders that help the kelp float. In a growing period, it can grow anywhere between 45 to 60 metres in length, and a growing rate at roughly 60 centimetres a day. So I tried to knit 60 centimetres a day, and keeping up wasn't good. I didn't keep up. But I finished it, and it took about 72 days to do.
the floating out of the algae in the trays has been amazing to see how the plant forms. But also then we were using technology to photograph and to enlarge what we've seen in the trays. To go further than that, then to actually look at these, some parts of these plants under the microscope, gives you a whole new world. Not everyone can dive and see it in situ in the water. I myself don't dive, so I can't do that. But I can look at it, you know, floating out in a shallow tray. Looking inside the secret life of algae.
So brown algae are known as the Phaeophyci. The red algae are the rotophyta, and greens are the chlorophyta. Identifying algae is an incredibly simple or complicated task, depending on how you approach it. In the field, or as you're walking along the beach, you can easily pick something up and identify traits about it. Is it red? Is it brown? Is it slimy? You know, is it green? Is it papery? All of these sort of gross morphological characters. When it comes down to identifying individual species, it gets much more complicated. And some of the traits that define species are microscopic. And in some groups, there are really high levels of cryptic diversity. So there's actually nothing, no anatomical traits that we can easily see that will actually define species. They're truly cryptic and they can look more or less identical. So that in that case, we might identify them through genetics, something like DNA barcoding.
I always love to learn. And so if I'm learning something new every day, that's perfect. And I am learning heaps in this.
The Holdfast to us became the linchpin of our project, because it is the attachment point and the anchor. And we thought that that was an interesting aspect to focus on, particularly as we started this during COVID. And I think a lot of people were looking for something concrete that they could hang on to.
We've had several workshops that were all funded. And we started off with a couple with just getting to know the algae. And then we had printmaking workshops as well. And an exhibition at the end of it, held at the Port Mac Community Complex. And the exhibition was fabulous. It was so good to see some of these people actually showing their work. They've said, oh, but you know, I'm not an artist, or, you know, I've only just done this couple of drawings, but they did really well.
I love our teddy bear weed out here, whatever it's called. So that inspired me when I sat down and I drew my little teddy bear, I was gone. I didn't matter who was in the room, then I was enjoying putting all the layers. I do colour pencils, so I was able to layer colours on. And to me, that was a great form of therapy. So artwork is this stuff. If you go down to the sea, do it there. Thanks, Sal. So this guy, look at this little guy. And the kids, because I take lots of walks here with school kids and visitors all over the world, and I often point out to them that we've got hundreds of teddy bears out here, and it's one of my favourites. One of the greatest ways to really connect with our country is to take your boots off. When I bring people down here on these beaches, we often encourage school kids and troubled adults even, take your boots off and ground yourself. The electricity is absorbed, anything nasty and poorly is absorbed and comes back. What you invest with taking your boots off, you get it back. It's mental well-being. It's really, really important. And I'd often do that. I would just come down here, roll my trousers up and just walk around bare feet. And unless you get prickles in your, like sea urchins or broken off bit of bull kelp or some other prickles off the reef, it's all pretty good. Keeps you awake if you do get a prickle.
The effect that it's had on several people, and they've actually made the comment that it has changed their lives in some ways, given them a special focus. And I guess that it's done that for me too, given me a special focus to be able to work on. So each day when I wake up, so, okay, what's on today? What can we achieve for the project on this day?